Yo, what's going on YouTube? Drum and Chris here. We're calling back at y'all with another vid. Today, I want to talk about some hold and sell. I know you guys like these videos, so I try to do these videos, especially for going on right now, is these tie-dye ones. My goodness, like this release was like, I think all of a sudden it just said like, hey, we just decided Nike, we're going to delay it, but yet they still come out on the foot sides. And since it's on, since there's no sneakers app, everyone's gonna go for that. And there's just so many people on there. It was really tough to get in. And yeah, it good luck out there because it was pretty tough. And you know, it was bought cities. And just the way how this release was, like honestly, I'm wondering if these things gonna restock again, like a couple times. You know what I mean? Because like you guys know, it's during this pandemic, how many restocks have we got from different other shoes and stuff like that? I get it, it's probably because like a lot of things just GR and store, so on and so forth, but this one here, it seems something's kind of different. I don't know, it's like they weren't ready for this release, or maybe they didn't have all their shipment in or something. Like something's up. So I have a feeling that you guys, it's just a gut feeling, we might see a couple more really restocks, not just on the sneakers app, you know, that going on, but like we might see more restocks on other sites, or maybe an actual release, you know, who knows. But just stay tuned. If I get any information, I will let you guys all know. You guys already know it was basically bought city. It was really tough to get those things, man. And we'll see what happens on Monday. So let's just go ahead, let's just look at resale price right now on these things. As of right now, I knew the price is gonna be at its highest point right now. So from like, look, this is a women's shoe to remind you guys. So from a size 5 all the way up to about, I wanna say about 8, 8.5 in women's size, that's probably gonna be your most, you know, probably gonna be the cheapest price. And prices are like at 270, about 280 or something like that. Which is, you know, I do kind of see it staying at that price point. Like, you know, the highest asking is 270, the lowest bid is like 250 or something like that. And then we'll see once people get pairs, will it go down or up? I don't know. It's this shoe seems pretty limited, and it's gonna be, it seems like it's really tough to get. And of course, a size 9 up to a 10 is around, or a size 9 to a 9.5 is around that 300 range. And of course, the money size from a size 10 all the way up to about 11 is about that 330 to 340. And a size 12, which is like the biggest size, and that's going for like 400, lowest asking is 350. So that's pretty crazy right there. So I do see in prices kind of going down just a little bit. They're gonna go up even higher, especially after Monday once the release happens on the sneakers app. I do see price kind of spike up, but then, you know, now I want to talk about once everyone gets pairs and everyone starts to dump things, little Timmy's out there, you guys already know how it is, right? So from about a size 5.5 to about an 8.5, you're probably gonna look around that price at 270 to 250 range, you know, once it's all kind of said and done. And then from a size 9 to 9.5, probably around that 280, you know, 280 to 290, something like that, 300, okay, 300, 280. I'll give me a little room, okay? And of course, size 10, look, it's gonna be about that 300 range, you know? Right now it's gonna hit 350 by Monday. It's gonna hit probably 350, maybe even more, but right now I think the lowest bid is 300. So I think that's fair. It's probably gonna be around that 320 to 300 range, somewhere around there. Especially for a size 10, 10.5, and 11, 11.5, and 12, that's the biggest sizes they have, and you're looking around like that 380 to 350 range, and maybe a little lower, but you're gonna look around there, okay? So, hey, it is profitable, there is money to be made. They retail for 170, so you're looking about a couple hundred dollars for, you know, come up. And here, to me, this will be a decent hold, especially if you guys got big sizes. If you guys got a size from a 10 and up, definitely it's gonna be a really good hold. I do see in prices, these things could hit like, say, you know, already like 400, right? So they could be probably around that range. It'll go back up to about like that 400 range, maybe even a little more once, you know, time passes by. And it's gonna be like a long hold though, okay? It's not gonna be like, how's instant, like shoot up. Like, just imagine it with these things, all right? even though these were a lot more of these things. Just imagine that. At one point, these things were kind of like almost bricks. These things were only going for like 200, 250 or something like that, especially for smaller, bigger sizes. And now look at them, they're kind of been going up. And I do see these things continue to kind of come up. So big sizes, definitely a good hold. Small sizes, I would let go and just continue going. I mean, the small sizes will go up eventually, but not much, you know, maybe a couple dollars. But to me, this is definitely let go for small, hold for big, you know. And the bigs, I mean, sky's the limit. They could go up to like 450, 400, you know, in a couple months, 6 months to a year. So, especially with Air Jordan 1, it's a crazy colorway tie-dye. This is actually pretty fresh, man. Like, I definitely see people going after these things, and it's just one of those shoes, like, yeah. No, tie-dye, you know, the tie-dye color on shirts and stuff, it's in. So it's still good to go. Like, it's in, it's still trending, and it's still stylish. So this is a shoe that people could wear, and it's not gonna be like that crazy look wear, like something like this here. This is kind of crazy, but you know, the leather kind of makes up for it. So it's actually pretty fire. I felt like this shoe was a lot more limited than I anticipated. I didn't think it was gonna be like that, or maybe just the way how this release was, like with the delays and the confusion, and like when they break it up like that, like Footsie released today and then Nike released on that day, it always puts like, it's always trouble, man. It's always tough. I don't know why I have this here, sorry. I just like to compare this one. This is such a fire shoe. But it's always tough when they do that, and it just makes it difficult for everyone. So that when stuff like that happens, then it usually causes the price to continue going up. And that's what I think it's gonna be. It's gonna hit pretty high. Then they'll bottom out. But then if you can just hold it and just weigh the storm, trust me, these things are gonna do pretty well. They're gonna do just okay. Guys, I think they might do better than a lot of these Jordan 1s that we've been getting, you know, like the Court Purples, the Pine Greens, even the UNC to Chicago, even though I think those are a better shoe. But just during this time, I think these will do better. Time goes on, could they do even better? Probably, man. It seemed like this shoe is really limited. Like in my area, we only got, I think it was only two stores that got them. So that just tells me how limited they were, man. So, hey, good luck out there if you're trying to cop these things. I would wait till after Monday. So after the sneakers release and people get pairs, that's when I would buy. Because I think price will kind of dip down a little bit. At least they should, theoretically. But I'm looking for pairs. Anyone out there, if you guys got any tie-dyes, hit me up, man. I'm looking for pairs, any sizes, hit me up. Small, big, I really need a personal. I did get one W though, I got one W, so I'm excited about that. But if anyone got pairs, especially for my size, I'm looking for a 10 and a half or 11, so hit me up, please. But is this a shoe that you would invest in? It depends, you know, if you're willing to hold it. Like I said, if you have capital to hold, definitely hold for sure. For me, I like to invest in ones, you know, I like to have a couple pairs. These here, like I think people sleep on these things, and you know, I mean, the price is up right now, but later on, not that many people are really talking about it. I haven't talked to a lot of resellers that's like, yo, I need to invest in these. So, but to me, I think these things here, man, it's gonna be a good investment. How much? I don't think it's gonna be like crazy, but I think it's gonna be a pretty decent investment. This is a shoe that I wouldn't mind having a couple pairs, hold it away, and just wait, you know? Because, hey, like I said, this colorway is pretty fire, man. It's actually pretty nice tie-dye. I mean, we haven't got a tie-dye Jordan 1, and it's not too crazy. Like, this is a shoe that you can actually kind of go out and actually wear. And, you know, I think it looks really fire. So a shoe that I would mind investing in, and you guys should think about that too, especially big sizes, man. Big sizes is going to be a good investment too as well. Pretty much it for the video, guys. That's my little hold and sell for these tie-dyes. Let me know, how'd you guys do on these tie-dye Jordan 1s? Did you were able to get them today? I mean, I saw some people take some W's on Shoe Palace. I love all places, Shoe Palace. I've never ever got a W on Shoe Palace, man. That is such a tough site. I hate the whole timing thing and everything. Oh my god, it's such a freaking headache. But hey, shout out to everyone that got through. The foot size, I haven't seen that many people took a W just yet. I'm not sure they even releasing sizes, or I don't know what's going on, man. Foot size is just, they're just being such a, foot size are just being super difficult right now. But you know, I figured that was gonna happen, man. I'm sure that with the whole everything getting delayed and all that stuff, so you know, it is what it is. But Anyway, guys, that's pretty much end of the video, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you guys don't mind, please hit that thumbs up. Subscribe if you're first time here. Comment down below and please hit that bell for all the notifications for when I do drop vids. Don't forget to follow me on all my social media at JumpinChris on IG. Sometimes I'm on Twitter and don't forget Snapchat. Anyway, guys, I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. I'm JumpinChris. Peace.